Do we prefer a more sexually dimorphic mate for short-term mating and vice versa? Sexual dimorphism, the systematic difference in form between individuals of different sex in the same species. The differences in appearance between males and females of the same species, such as in color, shape, size, and structure. Human male and female appearances are perceived as different, although Homo sapiens has a low level of sexual dimorphism compared with many other species, it plays an important role in determining attractiveness. More dimorphic people are considered more sexually attractive by their opposite gender, of course within balance. For example, taller men with wide shoulders are considered attractive by females, and short females with big breasts and wide hips are considered more attractive by males. Sexual dimorphism is also found in human faces. A study was done in 2018 on sexual dimorphism and facial attractiveness. In this study, male and female participants viewed the target male and female faces that varied in attractiveness and sexual dimorphism. Female and male faces were morphed into masculine and feminine and then were presented to the participants for judgment. The results of simple effect analysis are as following. For male face images, both men and women participants rated masculine stimuli as more attractive than feminine ones under the more attractive condition, but rated feminine stimuli as more attractive than masculine ones under the less attractive condition. For female face images, all the participants rated feminine stimuli as more attractive than masculine ones under the less attractive condition, but there were no differences between feminine and masculine stimuli under the more attractive condition. There is considerable evidence that sexual dimorphism is one of the important factors influencing facial attractiveness. Masculine characteristics of male faces reflect higher levels of testosterone. Similarly, feminine characteristics of female faces are positively related to higher estrogen levels. From the perspective of evolutionary theory, these typical secondary sexual characteristics may be reasonably reliable indicators of good genes, which are positively related to physical health. Thus, masculine male and feminine female faces have been considered to be more attractive than feminine male and masculine female faces. With that being said, do we prefer more sexually dimorphic mates for short-term relationships? To understand this, we need to look at three major studies.
In our experiment, most women chose one of these two guys here as their future husband. But when looking for a one-night stand, they tended to go for this guy here. And there's a good scientific reason for their choice. Why do you find these guys attractive?
I like the cheekbones and the jaw.
He is definitely like the strong jawline.
The stubble, the eyes,
the jaw.
Yeah.
High cheekbones.
He's got a little bit darker eyes.
Women find these things attractive because they're all signs of high testosterone, which means that the man is healthy and strong.
Strategic pluralism suggests that women should generally engage in long-term mating strategies. However, if the benefits, example, genetic benefits for offspring, outweigh the costs of short-term mating, example, less parental investment, partner loss, unwanted pregnancy, etc., then women should take advantage of short-term mating opportunities. Evidence for strategic pluralism comes from women's preferences across the menstrual cycle. Because masculinity in faces, voices, body shape, and social displays, for a review of the previous three factors, is associated with high testosterone levels and testosterone is an immunosuppressant, highly masculine healthy males are likely to be particularly immunocompetent. Immunocompetency is a heritable genetic benefit available to a woman's offspring, thus, women engaging in short-term relationships should prefer highly masculine mates. Research has demonstrated that fertile women, as compared to non-fertile women, prefer higher levels of masculinity in faces and voices, as well as dominant male social displays. Further evidence of strategic pluralism in human mating is demonstrated through research investigating the interindividual difference of sociosexual orientation. Sociosexual orientation represents a person's openness to short-term mating. People with relatively unrestricted sociosexual orientation, indicated by high scores on the sociosexual orientation inventory, are more likely to engage in short-term relationships than people with a restricted sociosexual orientation. Generally employing a short-term mating strategy, as compared to a long-term mating strategy, yields fewer non-genetic resources, i.e., parental effort, and increases the importance of receiving genetic benefits from sexual partners. Thus, similar to women at times of peak fertility, women with unrestricted sociosexuality should prefer high levels of masculinity. Work by Provost, Cormas, Kosakowski, and Quincy has demonstrated that unrestricted sociosexuality is related to greater attraction to the masculine mesomorph body type, as compared to average, endomorph, or ectomorph body types, and attraction to a male confederate for short-term relationships in a mock speed dating paradigm. A 2015 study named Women's Preferences for Penis Size found that women may prefer a smaller penis size in a long-term partner compared to a one-time partner, for reasons of both physical comfort and a preference for less masculinity in a longer-term partner. Which do suggest that females prefer more dimorphic partners in short-term mating. A 2007 study named Contribution of the Face and Body to Overall Attractiveness suggests that men prefer high bodily attractiveness in short-term mating but emphasize more on facial attractiveness in long-term mating, which can be related to higher dimorphism in bodies and short-term mating. But why do we prefer that? I didn't find scientific evidence behind it, but the most logical reasoning that comes to my mind is promiscuity. High dimorphic people look promiscuous because of their sex appeal and may possess a threat of being not loyal in a relationship. A study does reveal that men do not prefer promiscuous women in long-term mating and vice versa. Another reason is maybe highly dimorphic people do not look so romantic. Note how major romantic films actors don't look promiscuous at all. This doesn't mean that other people can't be desired for short-term mating. Here it's a matter of more. Who do you think has been with more women? This also can be a role of fisonomy. We do not prefer more dimorphic mates because they do not look loyal. Keep in mind that this is my theory and it might be wrong or might not be wrong. Please let me know in the comments which person you would choose for hookups and a long-term relationship. Personally, I would choose F1 because she doesn't look promiscuous. If you want to get a scientific analysis of your face or want to improve your looks, head over to our website and order a custom report according to your needs. You can also follow us on Instagram and join our Telegram group. All the links will be in the description box.